As white women, we need to use our privilege to make positive changes.
Ariel Fodor, affectionately known as Mrs. Frazzled, is here to help gentle parent us through this election.
Thank you. Hi, everybody. I am so honored to speak today. I am like shaking to just be among such incredible company. We are here because, as if you were here earlier, you've heard BIPOC women have tapped us in as white women to step up, listen, and get involved this election season. This is a really important time, and we all need to use our voices and influence for the greater good. No matter who you are, you are all influencers in some way. Spoiler alert, as much as the toxicity can come from the outside, it can come from us too. So first, don't isolate yourself. We can do our best work when we're in community together like we are tonight, because the toxic feels smaller when we support each other. But don't make it about yourself. As white women, we need to use our privilege to make positive changes. If you find yourself talking over or speaking for BIPOC individuals, or God forbid, correcting them, just take a beat. And instead, we can put our listening ears on. So do learn from and amplify the voices of those who have been historically marginalized, and use the privilege you have in order to push for systemic change. As white people, we have a lot to learn and unlearn. So do check your blind spots.
You to do me a favor and let's put on our listening ears and say nothing, okay? I don't owe you sh-. Go f- yourself with your little stupid f- Zoom call, okay?
First of all, I'm not sure it's a really good look for the Democratic Party to host a whites-only space event. I don't know that we want to take our country back to something like that, even if it is coming from the Democratic Party.
Because she is a woman, she also will listen and lead with empathy, integrity, and the power of the truth.
I don't know if you're aware, but when we got our vaginas, we got a truth-telling vibe that you men just don't have. It's a little known secret of women. I really appreciate Connie Britton underscoring that for everybody.
They can't even define what a woman is. Half of men are women, according to these people. And I think that you brought me on to torture me here.